sexual reproduction in angiosperm, a very interesting process in the topic. Here we have to see how reproduction takes place in angiosperm, as angiosperm are highly advanced and well adapted land plant. Sexual reproduction, as we know, require two compatible gametes or sexes. In angiosperm, for sexual reproduction, special organ is produced by the plant. That organ is called flower. Function of flower is to produce haploid gametes and to ensure that fertilization will take place. As we know, process involve meiosis and fertilization. And only after sexual fertilization, sexual reproduction, there is a formation of fruit and seed. Here in this topic, we have to study sequential step during which formation of fruit and seed is there. So how sexual reproduction takes place, that we are going to study. For that, first we should know structure of flower. Flower is highly modified and condensed shoot specially designed for sexual reproduction. So we start here with flower. Typical flower shows three main parts: pedicel, thalamus and floral whorls. Floral whorls are the circles of floral leaves. Floral whorls basically classified into two types: accessory whorls and essential whorls. Accessory whorls are two, calyx and corolla, and essential whorls are two, androecium and gynoecium. Here, calyx and corolla are called accessory whorl because these two whorls are not directly involved in the process of sexual reproduction, while androecium and gynoecium are essential because these are the reproductive whorls. Androecium is a male reproductive whorl and gynoecium is a female reproductive whorl. Without this whorl, sexual reproduction and fertilization is impossible. That's why androecium and gynoecium are called essential whorls. Here we have to study structure of flower with the vertical section of a flower. This is a flower in vertical section. Flower always studied in vertical section because that exposes all the parts of flower very clearly. Here you can see it is a stalk of flower which is called pedicel. When pedicel is present, flower is called pedicellate, and if there is no pedicel, flower is called sessile. This is a swollen tip of pedicel. Swollen tip of pedicel, which is called receptacle, thalamus or torus. This thalamus or receptacle is an important part because it holds all the four floral whorls or all the circles of floral leaves. As just we have seen, first outermost whorl of a flower is called calyx. Member of calyx is called sepal. Individual member of calyx is called sepal. In this diagram, we have to label it sepal because though it is a section, all the members of calyx are not visible. So, in spite of calyx, you have to label here sepal. You observe that, we always observe that buds of any flower always appear green in color because that bud is completely covered by a calyx. That means main function of calyx is protection. It protects the flower, particularly in the bud condition. Usually sepals are green in color, so perform photosynthesis. Here in this flower, sepals are free from each other. So when sepals are free, calyx is called polysepalous, and when sepals are fused, you observe flower of hibiscus, all the sepals fuse to form a green tube. So when sepals are fused, calyx is called gamosepalous. So calyx is a outermost accessory whorl of a flower. Inner to calyx, second whorl of flower is there, which is called corolla, and here petal, which is a member of corolla. You can see here petals make the flower beautiful. So usually petals are variously and brightly colored. That's why their main role is to attract the biotic agents for pollination, to attract the insect for pollination. This is also accessory whorl. Its function is attract the insect for pollination, and it also protect the inner important essential whorl. Calyx and corolla are not directly involved in the process of sexual reproduction, so they are called accessory whorl. Now, two important whorls which are very essential for sexual reproduction are androecium and gynoecium. Androecium is a male reproductive whorl, and gynoecium is a female reproductive whorl. Members of androecium are called stamens. Members of androecium are called stamens, and stamen here show parts anther, filament, one more part is there called connective. Female reproductive whorl, gynoecium, is made up of member called carpel, and typical carpel shows three parts, stigma, style and ovary. Every part perform a particular function. So, to study sexual reproduction, we have to study in detail about the sex organs, that is stamen, and about the carpel. Here, this flower is called bisexual because both male and female reproductive whorls are present in a same flower. But if in a flower there is no gynoecium and only androecium is present, suppose in a flower gynoecium absent and only androecium present, only stamens are present, then that flower is unisexual but male, because androecium represent male reproductive whorl, so that is called as male flower. Male flower also called as staminate flower. And if in a flower androecium is absent and only gynoecium present, again that flower is unisexual, but now it is unisexual female flower, and female flower is called pistillate flower because gynoecium also called pistil, P-I-S-T-I-L, it is also called pistil. Now, we are going to study in detail about two important words, androecium and gynoecium. First, male reproductive whorl. So, androecium is a male reproductive whorl of a flower. An individual member of androecium is called stamen. As I told you, stamen consists of anther, connective and filament. Now, this anther may be dithecous or monothecous. That means, if in an anther two lobes are there, it is called dithecous, and in an anther if single lobe is there, it is called as monothecous. Immature anther, when anther is not fully matured, it consists of parenchyma tissue surrounded by single layered epidermis, a group of parenchyma cell surrounded by epidermis. Its differentiation takes place when some of the hypodermal cell get transformed into the archisporial cell, and then archisporial cell divide to inner sporogenous cell and outer primary parietal cell. Sporogenous cell forms sporogenous tissue, and parietal cell undergo division to form anther walls. So roughly I explain it to you. This is immature anther, as I explained, made up of group of parenchyma cell surrounded by single layer of epidermis. Then cells below the epidermis are called as hypodermal cell. This hypodermal cell form archisporial cell. That archisporial cell divide and form outer and inner cell. Outer cells toward the periphery form parietal cells and inner cell form the sporogenous cell. Later on, parietal cell contribute in the formation of anther wall and sporogenous cell form sporogenous. Anther is a fertile part of a stamen. As stamen made up of three part, anther, filament and connective. But filament and connective are not fertile part. Only anther is a fertile part where formation of microspore or pollen grain takes place. That's why we are studying transverse section of anther. Internally, anther consists of two parts only, anther wall and pollen sacs or microsporangia. Now you remember, if anther is a dithicus, two-lobed, it contains four pollen sac or microsporangia, it is tetrasporangiate. But if anther is monothicus, having single lobe, then anther contains only two pollen sacs or two microsporangia. Okay, so anther consists of two parts, anther wall and microsporangia or pollen sac. Anther wall comprises of four layers: epidermis, endothecium, middle layer and tapetum. Outermost is epidermis and innermost is. This is a transverse section of anther, and here all the steps which are involved in the formation of male gamete. We have started with the androecium as a male reproductive whorl. It is deployed in nature. Then androecium is made up of members called as stamen, also deployed. In a stamen, three parts are there: anther, connective and filament. But anther is fertile. That's why we have to mention here only anther, which is also diploid. Then anther contains microsporangia. As I told you, if anther is dithicus, four microsporangia. If it is monothicus, only two microsporangia. Microsporangia also called as pollen sacs, which are also diploid. Inside the microsporangia, formation of microspore mother cell takes place. Microspore mother cell also diploid. But when in a microspore mother cell there is a meiosis, haploid microspores are formed. Microspore develop into male gametophyte, and in the male gametophyte male gametes are present. So it is a sequence from androecium to male gamete which shows us how male gametes are produced by the androecium. And step by step, we are going to study all the event. Now, this is a transverse section of anther. This is a dithicus anther, two lobes, very clear two lobes are there, showing its transverse section. So, dithicus, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 pollen sacs are there. Here it is a transverse section. We are going to study first anther wall. This is a outermost layer. As we know, it is called epidermis, and you can see it is a common wall layer. Pure anther ko isne surround kiya hai, common wall layer hai. Choti cell hai, barrel shape ki hai, closely packed hai aur thin walled hai. And though it is outermost layer, it is protective in nature. Inner to epidermis, one more layer is there, which is also single layered, and it is also a common wall. Pure anther ko dekho, isne surround kiya hai. This is also a common wall layer. But we can easily differentiate the cells from the cells of epidermis because cells are larger in size than the cells of epidermis. Here, this is endothecium, and cells of endothecium are differentiated because of presence of callous thickenings on the cell. And this layer endothecium is important because this layer helps in dehiscence of anther. क्योंकि एंथर से एट द टाइम ऑफ मैच्योरिटी पोलन ग्रेन बाहर निकलते हैं, तो पोलन ग्रेन को बाहर निकलने के लिए एंथर वॉल का ब्रेक होना जरूरी है। तो एंथर वॉल ब्रेक होने के लिए जो लेयर हेल्प करती है वो लेयर कौन सी है? एंडोथेशियम। सो दिस एंडोथेशियम ऑल्सो कॉमन वॉल लेयर शोइंग अ कैलोस थिकनिंग एंड हेल्प इन डिहिसेंस ऑफ एंथर। इनर टू एंडोथेशियम यू कैन सी थ्री लेयर्स आर देयर, थ्री टू फोर लेयर्स आर देयर विच आर कॉल्ड एज मिडल लेयर्स, विच आर कॉल्ड एज मिडल लेयर। अब देखो मिडल लेयर कॉमन नहीं है, हर एक पोलन सैक के बाहर से मिडल लेयर का अलग अलग सर्कल है यहाँ पर। तो मिडल लेयर्स आर नॉट कॉमन वॉल लेयर्स एंड मिडल लेयर्स देयर इज नो डेफिनेट फंक्शन ऑफ मिडल लेयर एंड दीज आर डिसइंटीग्रेट एट द टाइम ऑफ मैच्योरिटी। सो हियर यू कैन सी नो मिडल लेयर्स आर देयर, सो मिडल लेयर्स आर डिसइंटीग्रेट एट द टाइम ऑफ मैच्योरिटी। नाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इनरमोस्ट लेयर विच इज कॉल्ड एज टपेटम which is in close contact with the microsporangia or pollen sac. Here you can see. And cells are very clear. Cells are large in size and very important because tapetum cell secrete a substance which is called as sporopollenin. And sporopollenin become a part of pollen grain, particularly outer layer of pollen grain called as exine having a sporopollenin. And second important function is it is nutritive in function. तो इसके अंदर जो sporogenous tissue है जिससे spore बनने वाले हैं उसको proper nourishment मिलना चाहिए, that nourishment is given by the cells of tapetum. Okay, so these are the three anther wall layers, four anther wall layers, epidermis, endothecium, middle layers and tapetum function protection, dehiscence में help करते हैं, no definite function and disintegrate at the time of maturity, tapetum secrete sporopollenin and second function provide nutrition to inner sporogenous cell. Now in this sporogenous cell, very important part because here pollen grains are formed. Here in the sporogenous cell, from the sporogenous tissue, cells are differentiated which are called as microspore mother cells. अभी तुमको मैंने sequence दिखाया था slide का कि inside the microsporangia microspore mother cell form. That microspore mother cells are diploid and from microspore mother cell haploid microspores are formed. Once more, here again TS of anther, epidermis, then endothecium, middle layers, very clear tapetum and here microspores which are formed in the pollen. Now in the pollen sac, diploid microspore mother cells are present. Microspore mother cell undergo meiosis, M1, M2, reduction division, equational division. Four cells are formed which are in a group so called as pollen tetrad. And you remember usually tetrahedral tetrad is formed. So pollen grains in a group called as pollen tetrad. So from microspore mother cell by meiosis here pollen grains or microspores are formed. You can see microspore mother cell is diploid and pollen grains or microspores are haploid. This is a very important process called as microsporogenesis. So what is microsporogenesis? Formation of haploid microspore from diploid microspore mother cell by meiosis. Formation of haploid microspores from diploid microspore mother cell by meiosis is called microsporogenesis. Pollen grains, important structure, form inside the anther, inside the pollen sac. Now, function of pollen grain or microspore is to develop into male gametophyte. Before starting development of male gametophyte, we should know structure of pollen grain. Structure of pollen grain. So, what is their structure? That we are going to study in next lecture.